Welcome back. The stock on our radar is Escorts. What a big mover right now. We are seeing it at the high point of trade, and most of that had come by as soon as the company announced its deal with Kubota, where Kubota will go ahead and increase their stake. In fact, we have the management, a conversation with the management of Escorts. Let's hear it out.
Hello and welcome to this special coverage of the big story today. Japanese company Kubota is all set to increase its stake in Escorts. Kubota's stake will go from 9% to 54% via an open offer route, where they will they have announced the open offer for 2,000 rupees a share. We have with us the deal makers themselves, Nikhil Nanda, the chairman and managing director of Escorts, and Yuichi Kitao, the president and representative director at the Kubota Corporation. Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us. Nikhil, I want to start with you. Congratulations first on the deal. Since you do hold about 14% stake in Escorts, tell us a little bit about what the rationale is behind this deal and what happens to your stake eventually.
So, Sonia, firstly, thank you very much. I think this is a very proud moment for the country and for Escorts and for my personal family. It's a historic day where a partner like Kubota is going to join hands with the Escorts to create a very powerful charter of making a farm mechanization solution of products of what we would introduce jointly for the Indian market. I'm extremely excited with the synergies of what will be brought in from Japan and what Escorts has already developed in the past few years. I think the products are going to complement each other, and the kind of products that we will add in addition to the tractors like harvester machines and other farm mechanization products will further add to the entire impact that we want to create as a company between Kubota and Escorts. For me, this was an important decision at Escorts because as a family member, it is my fiduciary responsibility to ensure Escorts has the best of ingredients. And I think with this deal, not only we get technology, we also create an institution out of Escorts. Escorts will get the best of processes. We will have global access to markets through Kubota distribution network. And I think the future will only create excitement from all aspects, be it a supplier who will have larger, promising supply chain businesses and the distributors who are going to get the best of processes to distribute the products that we will jointly.
So just to follow up there, Nikhil, we do understand that you will continue to be the chairman and managing director of Escorts. But what happens to that 14% stake that you own? At any point in time, would you be looking to sell further? And any change in the management structure at all?
So, Sonia, I want to put all the rumors to rest. There is no intention whatsoever to sell any shares from the Nanda family. We are totally committed. Mr. H.P. Nanda, the founder of Escorts, laid the foundation and the platform of Escorts to serve the nation, to provide farm mechanization products for the larger good. I, as a third generation representative, I'm totally committed to carry that legacy forward. So I would just want to confirm that in this transaction, the family has not sold any shares. We are actually doubling down on the vision of what Kubota and Escorts will build together. And I think with today's transaction, I feel proud that we are going to institutionalize and Escorts flag will always will stand tall in the domestic market and for the international market.
Okay, so that clarification is very important. Let's get Yuichi Kitao as well. He's the president of Kubota Corporation. Mr. Kitao, you tell us, I did read the press release that Kubota put out where they're very optimistic on the India farm equipment business. But what are the synergies and what are the future plans that Kubota has for India?
Escorts will be positioned as an important base of value for the money machinery in India and globally. Kubota plans to expand the scope of collaboration from tractors to the entire machinery business, like combined harvesters, construction machinery, and engines, as Nanda-san said. At the same time, we will promote other power sources, such as electric tractor, as an important theme to realize carbon neutral society. So all agricultural machinery areas are target areas for the both companies for the future. So I'm very excited to make a business much, much bigger together with Escorts.
Less than 10% stake in 2018, when you first bought 9% stake in Escorts, to now, going all the way up to more than 50% if the open offer is successful. What's been your experience in the last 4-5 years in Escorts, and where you think this joint venture is going to take the combined entity to in the next few years from now?
We have a discussion between Escorts and Kubota for several years, and Nanda-san and I talking about the future expansion of the business, and we have committed. We are committed to make both businesses strong all over the world.
Okay, Nikhil. Same question to you as well. You know, Kubota has been with you in the last 4-5 years. They bought first 9% stake, and now looking at a major partner in this company. What has been your learnings when they came in? And, you know, as a combined entity, what's the kind of vision that you look forward to for this company over the next few years from now?
You know, I'm very, very excited. You know, I think when the relationship started, when I met with Kitao-san first in 2016-17, it was just a manufacturing JV. Then last year, as you're aware, they came in at 10% equity in Escorts, and Escorts took 40% in their sales and distribution network company. With this deal, you know, we are making one entity, one value, one vision, one goalpost. I think now our aspiration is to create a leadership position in the next 5 to 10 years. Between Kubota and Escorts, we are building a medium-term business plan where we are detailing out what kind of products we're going to develop, what kind of products we are going to distribute in India, what kind of hybrid products in terms of the learnings that the two companies can bring in, create the kind of innovative and products which are absolutely, you know, world-class. So there are a lot of aspects that the companies are debating, thinking, planning. And I think the learning is about putting all of this detailing into a very, very, you know, in a process-oriented manner to execute it, to give that wow impact to all the consumers in India and overseas. So we have a branding strategy, which we have already spoken about, the product strategy. And I can't speak in terms of numbers, but all I can say is there are, as Kitao-san rightly mentioned, we have some very large plans. And I think India and Japan coming together, this partnership will create one of the most powerful platform of products between in the agriculture space, beyond tractors in the full farm solution space.
Yeah. Nikhil, coming to the deal, you know, you very clearly clarified that the promoters are not going to sell any stake. And you know, the question is on the open offer part. If the larger shareholders don't participate in the open offer, will the Nanda family or the promoters tender in the open offer to make sure that the Kubota stake goes up to 50%?
I think all of these options are something we will explore. It's premature for me to comment. I think the board has taken a conscious decision, and we have already shared with you about the decision that we have taken between ourselves and the board. I hope for the best outcome, and we will decide when we need to decide vis-a-vis the question that you've asked. I think it'd be premature for me to answer anything at this stage.
Okay, just a final question from my end then, Nikhil. You know, Escorts is always known as a tractor maker, but we know that Escorts is into several other businesses, whether it's, you know, in construction, engineering, even in railways, and Kubota has a large presence in that space as well. As a combined entity, what could the synergies be apart from tractors? We do know that Kubota is very optimistic on the combined harvester space as well, but where all do you see the potential over the next couple of years, Nikhil?
So Sonia, apart from tractors, you know, we're looking at harvester machines. There are other engine aspects. Engine also would be something we'll be looking at. There'll be other components and aggregates for tractors and harvesters that we will look at. Construction also, as you're aware, Kubota is very strong in the mini excavators. And that is another aspect that we are going to evaluate and assess of how we can create a market for that in India. And all of what we are thinking in terms of the products between Kubota and Escorts will be products that would be built to distribute in India, but also India will become one of the most important hubs for Kubota to use India as a buyback because of the fact that India is so strong in its supply chain and its frugal engineering. And I think that's another component of aspect of the partnership that will add a lot of value for Kubota and in terms of making products competitive, but using one of the finest of technologies for the future. Mm-hmm. So there's lots on the table, Sonia. As I said, I'm deeply excited. It's a historic moment for Escorts, historic moment for the country. And all I can say is that between Kubota and Escorts, we are deeply, deeply committed to giving the best to our customers and doing what is required to meeting all the aspirations and expectations of our shareholders.
Nikhil, I agree. You know, it's a big deal for you and for the country as well. Last word from you, how the board will change after this whole deal? Will there be more representatives from Kubota who will join the board now?
So the board will continue. We are very fortunate to have a very strong board. I'm also deeply indebted and would like to give all the acknowledgement of thanks to my board of directors who have helped Escorts and me to come to this stage with Kubota. We continue to get guidance from them. The idea of this partnership is to build, is not to take away. And I think whether it's a board, whether there are KMPs, I think Sonia asked me that question earlier, that the KMP and the leadership team will continue. I will continue to be the chairman managing director. So therefore, the trust that we have built between Kubota, between Kitao-san, Watanabe-san, I think is the ingredient of the platform and the foundation to build for the future plans. And we want to assure that the continuity is going to be the essence of what we build for the future.